Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you briefly about my experience with PCOS and metformin. Okay, so I'm not going to go into my whole PCOS story, but I want to tell you a little bit about what happened to me whenever I took metformin for PCOS. It was clear that I was insulin resistant, and this was in my 20s. This was probably like 26, 27 years old, shortly after I got married, a couple years after I got married. And I was having symptoms where I wouldn't bleed for 6 months, and then I would bleed, and it'd be like 30 days. I mean, that was just a normal thing in my life. And during that time, my doctor wanted me to, when I wasn't bleeding, he would give me progesterone pills to take for 10 days and it would make the bleeding start. Or like if he wanted to regulate my period, he would put me on birth control pills or something like that. And I'm sure you all who have had experience with PCOS, y'all know that story inside and out, and you can probably write a book on it. But I want to talk to you about what happened whenever I started taking the metformin for PCOS. So I had had a colonoscopy in my 20s because I couldn't go to the bathroom. I was constipated. And I was constipated because of my diet. I mean, that's the reality of it. And I had been constipated my whole life, really. So I had gotten the colonoscopy, and my endocrinologist that scheduled the colonoscopy said, you know, I want you to try this metformin to see how you do. And I want you to drink a lot of water. And I want you to walk 3 times a week for 30 minutes. And he gave me a prescription for all of that. And I started taking the metformin. And I can tell you, I started to lose weight. The weight started to come off of me. I actually started to feel better. I could tell that my insulin and sugar levels were leveling out. Like, I felt better. I didn't have diabetes or anything like that, like at that time, but I was insulin resistant and I did start to feel better. But after a while being on that metformin, and I want to say after about a month, because I didn't stay on it very long, I started getting side effects. Like I just didn't feel right in my body. Like, my body didn't like being on medication. So I stopped taking it and the symptoms came right back. If anybody has insulin resistance and they are taking metformin, it does what it says it does. Like, it will level out your sugar levels. You will get into a level place where maybe your body will start to lose weight, especially if you combine it with, you know, the standard American healthy diet, if you understand what I'm saying, what the doctors say is healthy. You'll start to get some results. But literally, it wasn't the answer for me because I couldn't maintain that. I didn't want to be on medication. And it was destroying my liver. That's what I believe was actually happening then. And there was a better way, because at the time, I believe, if I'm remembering correctly, they were recommending that I be on a high protein, low carb diet, which that's the diet that they recommend for people who have PCOS, which now I know is not the best place for somebody in that situation to be, because the reason that people have PCOS is because of estrogen dominance. And when you're eating all that protein, meat, you're getting the excess estrogen in your body and it's causing the problem to perpetuate itself. Even though your sugar levels might be leveling out, your estrogen levels are still like this because of all the meat that you're eating. So that was what my experience was. I could not maintain it, and my body was actually not on a healing path. It was being patched. That's probably the best way to describe it. And I might get a lot of backlash from this explanation, and really I don't care because I'm sitting here free from PCOS and have been free for a long time, so I know what I'm talking about. PCOS is healed through diet and lifestyle, and yes, you might need to take some supplements too, but I'm telling you, you don't ever have to have another PCOS symptom ever again in life, and it's not difficult to get to that place. So if you're interested in learning more about how to get to that place of healing with PCOS, please, by all means, write your questions down below in the comment section. I'll be glad to answer them. Also, if you want to look on my channel and you just type in PCOS, probably in the search bar, you can probably find at least 6-7 videos that talk about PCOS and my journey and what types of things I did so that I could get well from it. But I will do a specific video if you want to hear it. So go ahead and put that below. Share this video with anybody you know that you think might be experiencing problems with PCOS. And I'd be glad to share my experience, because you can be free from PCOS. I don't care what they say about it not being healing. Like, there not being a cure for PCOS. That's not true. So anyway, y'all. Oh, and I also have a friend, a close friend, who had it her whole life. And like in her 48th year, she finally got freedom from it. So I know it. I mean, I'm not the only one. There's story after story after story of people who've been healed from PCOS. It's just, it's really up here where the change has to happen, and the change here. All right, y'all. Talk to you soon. Take care.